have always prided myself on being a rather healthy person. I'm one of those people, I've never done drugs in my life. I've never smoked a cigarette. I have never, you know, done anything to have anything other than good health and health insurance. And then, you know, as I was going through part of my career, I was starting feeling tired and just not feeling well. And quite frankly, I attributed it mostly to stress. You know, it's a high pressure profile position. And then in December of 2006, I reunited with my natural parents for the first time in 4 years. And upon seeing them, they looked at me and they said, "Are you okay? You don't look well." And I said, "Well, I think I'm okay. I'm tired." And they said, "You know, we should let you know that your uncle died from pancreatic cancer 3 weeks ago. And we really think you need to go to the hospital." And I went to the doctors, and immediately they did an ultrasound, and they found tumors spread throughout my ovaries, my uterus, part of my bladder, part of my colon. And my doctors told me at the time, with all due respect, you know, this looks really bad and you might not make it through the surgeries, and we would advise you to, you know, tie up your loose ends, make sure you have everything taken care of. So that being said, we went into immediate surgery, and I began a basically a 3-year ordeal of 7 surgeries and fighting for my life. And basically, by finding my parents, I went home to Ohio to die. So they told me I wouldn't make it past my birthday. My birthday came. I'm still there. I'm in the hospital. I'm on an intravenous morphine pump with 27 other pharmaceuticals to stay alive. And I thought to myself, you know, I haven't died yet. There's no expiration tag on my toe that says I have to die. And if I'm going to be alive, quite frankly, I want to come home to California. Ohio was my home when I was a kid. I spent almost 30 years in Los Angeles, so I decided to come back. And one of the main reasons I decided to do that is I wanted to go for a holistic healing method for what was happening to me.
Sure, why did you turn it back?
Well, for me personally, my quality of life was horrible at the time. As I said, I was literally bedridden, in and out of hospitals constantly with an intravenous morphine pump. So even though I was alive, I was basically a zombie. I mean, I didn't have the strength to even get up and get up. And one of the things that I learned as being an optician is that medicinal marijuana does have medicinal properties, healing properties. I knew that it worked for glaucoma, and through the clinical advocate work that I had done, I knew that it had other healing qualities for cancer patients. I knew people who really felt the cannabis had completely healed them. So I talked to some people. I was afraid to stay in Ohio because, quite frankly, felony there, and I didn't want days of rest. So I decided to come back to California and went completely holistic. I rid myself of all of the pharmaceuticals, and I'm using cannabis specifically now to treat my illnesses. Now, the good news is I've made it through. I made it through 7 surgeries in 3 years of fighting. The ovarian cancer was gone. The other tumors that have got my bladder and my colon are gone. Unfortunately, on my last CAT scan, they found another massive tumor, 11.8 centimeter massive tumors that cover my entire liver. They drain through the fundus into the gallbladder and the stomach, so they're inoperable.
So what does this mean as far as what needs to be done with this?
Well, what this means is we need to go in for more testing to find out, number one, has it metastasized yet? And if it has, how much time do I have? So what happened very recently, actually it was January 12th of this year, just before my city council presentation, I went into the doctor, I had collapsed from a transient ischemic attack, they did some tests, they found some heart damage, and during the course of questions while I was in the hospital, the subject came up is, you know, so what is it that you do for a living? And I told the gentleman, I'm the executive director for Beverly Hills NORML. What is NORML? NORML is the National Organization for Reforming Marijuana Law. Then he asked the golden question, do you use cannabis? And I said, actually, yes, I'm a legal cannabis patient. He said, that's a problem, because your insurance is not going to approve any further testing, and you're certainly not going to have any chance of being on a liver transplant list, because cannabis is a Schedule 1 drug.
Wait, who's the doctor?
My doctor. Cannabis is a Schedule 1 drug, just like heroin. And I looked at him, I'm like, you're kidding me. I had no idea. So I asked him, I said, what do I do? I'm supposed to speak in front of the city council in less than 24 hours. He said, well, I would advise you to go directly into the hospital and you need to see what's happening, because right now I'm more concerned about your heart and I'm more concerned about your blood pressure. He says, but I'm also concerned we're going to be able to get your hospital testing approved I signed out against medical advice. Fred and I went from our Northern California farm, where we have our own medicinal garden. We came down to city council, and I testified in front of city council, and I realized I'd just been issued a death sentence from my insurance company. You know, for doing something that's legal in the state of California, and I'm a holistic path.
So you've been in touch with your insurance company? What have they said?
Well, we're having a lot of problems getting the right person to talk to, being passed to CEOs, spokesperson. No one really seems to want to respond. So that's why, fortunately, working with NORML, we're going to be taking this up with our congressmen, with our representatives in the state. And I want to get it resolved, of course, for myself. One of the things I've learned more importantly, people are dying every single day. I am far from the worst. There have been thousands of people who have died from these vague laws. So for me, I hope and I pray to God that I can stay healthy enough to fight for other people's rights and to educate the people of our entire community, the mainstream cannabis community, about what's happening for people being legal cannabis patients and being denied insurance rights that they've paid.
So